So students, under chapter body fluids and circulation, in our last class we have learnt about ECG, that is electrocardiograph, in detail. Let us recall what we have learnt in last class once again quickly, and we'll go to today's concept. Why I do recap, you know very well, because what you have learnt in last class should be connected to today's class. Then you will come to know in the textbook what comes after what, you know, you have to go in a series sequence, so your understanding should be continuous and it should be connected, you know it very well. Anyway, so we have learnt ECG or electrocardiograph in last class, where it is done to know function of heart, normal functioning of heart, or to know, electrocardiograph is done to know whether cardiac activity is normal or not, or electrical activity of heart is normal or abnormal. To know that, we do it. Okay, and the graph what we get in the ECG is called electrocardiogram. And how to connect this machine to the body with the three leads or three cables, and two cables are connected to both the wrists. Okay, left and right, and one cable is connected to the left ankle on the leg. Then if you want detailed monitoring of the heart or detailed study of electrical activity of heart, then chest should be connected with many leads. Many leads means many cables, so that detailed cardiac activity of heart you can notice. So what they do, standard ECG of all the people will be having graph like this. No, that is, this is called P, this is Q, this is R, S, T. So it shows P, Q, R, S, T. P indicates when auricles pump blood to the ventricle, that is called contraction of auricle or systole of auricle, or it is called depolarization of auricle. Then when ventricles pump blood to aorta and pulmonary artery, then it shows P, Q, R, S. That is also called contraction of ventricle or depolarization of ventricle or excitation of ventricle or what we call systole of ventricle. Then T stands for when ventricles come to normal position, that is relaxation, that is diastole of ventricle. That is what we have learnt in our last class. And any deviation from this shape, if any person's cardiac activity doesn't show this type of peak, if it is slightly deviated, small change is there with this graph, then it is indicated that it is abnormal heartbeat or his heart functioning is not proper. He has a problem in the heart. Okay, so this is what we have learnt in last class. So today we are learning double circulation. Anyway, you have learnt this in high school, but in detail we are going to learn today. Double circulation means, you know, blood comes two times to the heart. That is why it is called double circulation. Double means two times, twice. So blood comes twice to the heart, two times to the heart. That is left and right side. You know how it comes. First, we should start from lungs, because, you know, lungs, when we breathe in, we take oxygen and oxygen goes to alveoli of lungs. And from there, oxygen mixes with blood. That is oxygenated blood or oxygen mixed blood from the lungs through pulmonary veins, it comes to the heart. You know, from there you should start. So you start here with lungs. So through this tube, no, it should come to heart. Okay, so, and this is left auricle, left ventricle, right auricle, right ventricle, you know, from the lungs through pulmonary veins, that is a blood vessel which brings oxygenated blood. that is oxygen mixed with blood comes to left auricle, then from left auricle it goes to left ventricle. So from left ventricle through aorta, no, that is called dorsal aorta, it goes to all the body parts. So I have to show here body parts, no, at last I have to show body parts, all the body parts get oxygen. So till here you know, from the lungs oxygen mixed blood through pulmonary veins, that oxygenated blood comes to left auricle, then from left auricle oxygenated blood goes to left ventricle, then from left ventricle through aorta it goes to, oxygen mixed blood goes to all the body parts, then from all the body parts carbon dioxide is released, because carbon dioxide is waste here. So carbon dioxide mixed blood, carbon dioxide mixed blood comes to right auricle through vena cava, it is called great veins, because see, aorta is a artery, largest artery, it is great artery, and vena cava is a great veins, it is called. Vena cava brings carbon dioxide mixed blood, that is deoxygenated blood. If I have a colored chalk I can show, yes, oxygen I'll show in pink color. So pink color indicates oxygen mixed blood, blue color indicates carbon dioxide mixed blood for our understanding. Actually blue color is required, I don't have blue color, I think, yeah, it's there. So heart also we can show here pink, no? And here it is carbon dioxide mixed blood, so it is in blue color. Then you know, from all the body parts use oxygen, then release carbon dioxide. That carbon dioxide mixed blood through vena cava, superior and inferior vena cava, that comes to right auricle, then from there it goes to right ventricle, then from right ventricle through pulmonary arteries it goes back to lungs. See, beautiful diagram. So from all the body parts carbon dioxide is released as a waste, that carbon dioxide mixed blood through vena cava it comes back to right auricle, then from right auricle it goes to right ventricle, then from right ventricle carbon dioxide mixed blood, it is a waste, so it through pulmonary artery it goes back to lungs, and from lungs it goes out as waste product carbon dioxide. So through pulmonary artery, huh? Okay. So what we have to understand here is the wall of, which one is thicker, veins or arteries? If you notice that arteries wall should be thicker and veins wall should be thinner. So if you see aorta is an artery, so if you have to show this tube, artery, cross section of artery, it is thicker. only very small narrow opening is there. This is artery where walls are thicker, thick walls, because blood with force it is pumped into aorta, and aorta should be able to resist or control that pressure. When more pressure is there, it should be thick. Okay, then veins, that is vena cava, will have thinner, it will have a thinner wall because pressure will be decreased, less pressure is there, it can tolerate with thin walls also. That is why we have learned that walls of ventricle is thicker than auricles. See, you see there, vein wall is thinner, so it is thin wall. Okay, so if we see the, if we take a cross section of artery or vein, there are three layers. The outermost layer is with the connective tissue and collagen fibers called tunica externa. So this is, suppose artery or vein, when you take a cross section, if you cut the vein, it's like a tube. If you cut in the center and see, open it, and you see three layers are there, like three rings. Okay, so you see, I'm showing three rings here. The outermost is called tunica externa. Name only says externa, means outermost layer or wall of artery or vein. Okay, it is with fibrous connective tissue and collagen fibers. It contains tunica externa as the outermost cover of outermost layer of veins. That is, when you cut the vein or artery and see inside, it will have three layers. The outermost layer is called tunica externa. It will have fibrous connective tissue and collagen fibers, like a threads. Okay, then middle layer is called tunica media. Tunica media, media means middle layer, no? You can see there, tunica media. Okay, which is having smooth muscle and elastic fibers. Tunica media is having smooth muscles and elastic thread-like structures, that are elastic fibers. Then innermost is called as tunica intima. Tunica intima is an innermost layer. Okay, it is called endothelium. That is an innermost layer made up of squamous epithelial tissue. There is no space on here. So tunica intima is a innermost layer of a blood vessel, whether it is vein or artery. So it contains squamous epithelial tissue. It is also called endothelium, no? Because epithelium means outermost layer, endothelium means innermost layer. So this is a innermost layer, tunica intima. So it is called endothelium. It is made of squamous epithelium. That is, cells are arranged in one layer like this. All the cells are arranged in one layer like this. That is squamous epithelial tissues. Cells are arranged like this with a nucleus. Okay, so whether it is vein or Our tree, it will have three layers inside. Outermost is tunica externa, then innermost is tunica intima, middle is tunica media. Okay, this is what is structure of artery or vein. Then, other than this, what we have learnt, lungs will carry through pulmonary veins oxygenated blood to left auricle, then from left auricle blood goes to left ventricle, then through aorta it goes to body, all the body parts. That is, oxygenated blood goes to all the body parts. Then from all the body parts, carbon dioxide mixed blood through vena cava, it comes back to right auricle of the heart. Then it, from there it goes to right ventricle. Then through pulmonary artery, it goes back to lungs. This is what you have learnt in high school also, 10th standard also. Okay, even then, I have explained in detail. Then other than this, one more circulation is there. That is from intestine to the liver. This is very interesting part. It is called hepatic portal system. You know, word hepatic refers to liver. A recap is already done. This is thin wall. That is, from the intestine to liver, connection is there. There is a blood vessel which connects liver with intestine. Okay, that is called hepatic portal system. Hepatic word refers to liver. No, hepatic cells means liver cells. Portal means tube like. That is like a veins or artery. Hepatic portal system. That is from the intestine blood goes to liver. Okay, a unique vascular connection is there between digestive tract and liver. From the digestive tract, from the intestine, connection is there, blood vessel connection is there to the liver. So that is called hepatic portal system. Okay, so hepatic portal vein carries blood from intestine to the liver before it is released to systemic circulation. You know one thing, whatever oxygenated blood is transported from the left part of the heart, I am showing in pink color, that is called pulmonary circulation. You know this in high school, you have learnt it. It is called pulmonary circulation. So whatever blood is transported from left part of the heart, it is called pulmonary circulation. And whatever blood is transported from right part, it is called systemic circulation. See, right part of the heart, whatever blue color I am showing, that is deoxygenated blood. All that part is called systemic circulation. That is, deoxygenated blood from the body part to heart, heart to lungs, all this part, right side, whatever happens, all that is called systemic circulation. And on the left side of the heart, that is from the lungs, oxygenated blood goes to heart, from there it goes to body part, all that whatever blood circulation happens on the left part of the heart, it is called pulmonary circulation. They are talking about now, from the intestine, that is from the digestive tract, one blood vessel is there that is connecting intestine to liver. Why it is required? Because any waste product is there in the intestine that is transported to the liver and liver through special blood vessel, I told you, that is called portal vein. Through that portal vein, any waste which is there in the intestine goes to liver, and from the liver it is carried through this vena cava. I mean, it connects to the vena cava. So that any waste from the liver goes to vena cava, then from there it goes out. No? That is what is hepatic portal system. Okay. So I hope you understood what we are discussing here. Okay, this is called double circulation because you see here, from this side through pulmonary veins blood comes to the heart, and this side through vena cava blood comes to the heart. So blood comes to the heart two times. That's why word double is used, double circulation. Okay, that is blood comes to the heart two times or twice, so it is called double circulation. Next, we are going to learn control of circulation. That is, in our body, what controls blood circulation? Any part is there which can control blood circulation, increase or decrease heart rate? Heartbeat, increase or decrease in heartbeat is controlled by what? See, not only during physical activity, have you noticed sometimes when we are in fear, at that time also heartbeat increases. Like you were not at all prepared for a speech, suddenly somebody called your name on the stage and you are not at all prepared for it, and you don't know what is the topic also, then what happens? You'll be scared. You start thinking what other people will think about me, then heartbeat increases. You didn't do any physical activity or exercise, but heartbeat increases. That means some part is there in the body which can control circulation. That is, increasing heartbeat, decreasing heartbeat, control of beating of heart is by some part, that is regulation of circulation. Regulation means control. What controls blood circulation and heartbeat, we will see. This is also interesting part, because everybody wants to know what controls heartbeat in our body, what controls circulation in our body. Chalk. Regulation of blood circulation. Regulation is control. What controls blood circulation? Whether heartbeat should increase or it should decrease. Okay, all that is dependent on some part of the body that controls blood circulation. Or you can also say regulation of cardiac activity. Electrical activity of heart or normal functioning of heart is controlled by what in our body? We know that it is self-controlled, so it is auto-excitable. So normal activities of the heart are regulated intrinsically, means internally by itself. Okay, normal activity of heart is controlled intrinsically. Intrinsic means internal. Itself, it controls itself. Okay, it is under self-control. So auto-regulated specialized muscles are called auto-regulated, means self-controlled. Self-controlled AV tissue or nodal tissue is there in the body. You know this. Nodal tissue is SAN, sinoatrial node, and AVN. No? SAN present at the entrance of right auricle, and AVN, it is present at the entrance of right ventricle. Both will generate electric potential. So special tissue is there which is self-controlled, auto-regulated. Hence, heart is myogenic heart. So, AV tissue or nodal tissue is what? It's a special muscle tissue, specialized muscles. Okay, so nodal tissue, what is there? It is the nodal tissue, that is SAN and AVN, present at the right auricle and right ventricle, which generates electrical potential because they are auto-regulated, means self-controlled. Auto means self, regulated means control, auto-regulated special muscles, special muscular tissue, that is SAN and AVN. They generate electrical potential on their own without any stimulus. Okay, so they are auto excitable. So these muscles, because these muscles generate electrical potential and control itself the cardiac activity, that's why it is called myogenic heart. The word myo refers to muscles. Genic means to produce, because muscles produce electrical activity, that is why special muscles, that is AV tissue or nodal tissue, that is SAN and AVN, because special muscle of the heart controls heart activity or cardiac activity by generating electrical signals, that is why it is called myogenic heart. Myo means muscles, genic means producing. The myogenic meaning is muscles produce electrical activity, that is muscles produce action potential or sending signal for contraction and relaxation of heart, thereby it controls cardiac activity. That is why it is called myogenic heart. Okay, definitely it should be under control of autonomous nervous system or autonomic nervous system, which is self-controlled. Okay, so special neural center is there in medulla oblongata. Special neural center in medulla of brain, medulla oblongata of brain. So special nervous tissue or neural tissue is there in medulla oblongata of brain, which can moderate cardiac function through ANS. Moderate means, you know, change, increase or decrease cardiac function. Moderate or change cardiac function, because it is a part of ANS, autonomic nervous system. Auto meaning self, autonomic means self-controlled, autonomic nervous system, in short ANS. The meaning is whether heartbeat should be increased or decreased, that is moderate cardiac function means normal cardiac function, okay, is controlled by, normal cardiac function is controlled by medulla oblongata of brain, because medulla oblongata of brain is connected to autonomic nervous system, that is self-controlled. Okay, then neural signals through to increase heartbeat also ANS only controls, to decrease heartbeat also ANS only controls. How? Because you know that neural control and coordination chapter you have learned, autonomic nervous system has two parts. First one is sympathetic nervous system, other one is parasympathetic nervous system. No, ANS has two parts. Sympathetic can increase heartbeat by sending signal. Okay, so parasympathetic nervous system is opposite. Parasympathetic nervous system decreases heartbeat in simple terms. If I should say, sympathetic nervous system of autonomous nervous system increases heart rate, means it makes heartbeat faster, and parasympathetic nervous system of ANS decreases heartbeat or makes heartbeat slow. So thereby they control heart rate. Okay, so cardiac output is increased by sympathetic nervous system and cardiac output is decreased by parasympathetic nervous system. That means with sympathetic nervous system, the cardiac output, which is 5 liters per minute, will increase, and with parasympathetic nervous system, cardiac output, that is 5000 ml or 5 liters per minute, decreases. Less than that will happen. Okay, thereby increase or decrease in heartbeat is controlled by autonomic nervous system, and autonomic nervous system is connected to medulla oblongata. So medulla oblongata controls ANS, ANS controls heart rate by sympathetic and parasympathetic. Sympathetic increases heart rate, parasympathetic decreases heart rate. So thereby the sympathetic nervous system, how it can increase heart rate? By sending, by release of more signals, more electrical signals from SAN and AVN. So that when more action potential happens, then contraction, relaxation of muscles of heart will be more. So heartbeat increases. Parasympathetic nervous system will make SAN and AVN to release signals, electrical signals slowly, so that contraction and relaxation happens slowly. So heartbeat also decreases. Okay, that is how circulation or cardiac activity is controlled. So now we will discuss about last part of this chapter, that is disorders of circulatory system. We are going to discuss disorders of circulatory system. Okay, number one, hypertension or high BP. Hypertension or high blood pressure is also problem only, it is not normal. That is high BP. Normal BP is when normal BP or blood pressure, in 10th standard you have learned formula is SP by DP, that is systolic pressure. That is when contraction happens by diastolic pressure, that is when relaxation happens, pressure decreases. In systolic pressure, that is when 120 by 80 millimeter of mercury in sphygmomanometer. Do you remember the device which doctor used to measure blood pressure, by wrapping that, on the arm portion or biceps here, then they pump it, then through the like a thermometer, you see, that is called sphygmomanometer. In sphygmomanometer, if it shows 120 systolic pressure by 80 diastolic pressure, that is contraction and relaxation of heart per millimeter of mercury, because they use mercury in the thermometer, the tube there, it is sensitive. So it goes up to 120 and comes back to, drops to 80. That is normal BP. This is normal blood pressure. If more than 140 by 90 is there, this is considered high BP, high blood pressure. And this condition is only called hypertension, high blood pressure. If systolic pressure is more than 140, and diastolic pressure is more than 90, then it is called high BP or high blood pressure. Okay, you know this, you have learnt in high school. So high blood pressure leads to heart diseases and also affects vital organs like brain and kidney. If a person has hypertension or high BP, it affects other organs of the body. Okay, when blood pressure increases, it affects other part of the body, like especially brain and kidney. So kidney and brain will be affected if the person has hypertension. This is one problem. Then second disorder coronary artery disease. I'll rub this. Okay, this from your high school knowledge, you know this. Anyway, second one. Coronary artery disease. Can use capital letter, disease. Artery, A. Okay, so it is in short CAD. Coronary artery disease, C. Coronary C, artery A, this is D. Coronary artery disease. Okay, so coronary artery disease is also called as atherosclerosis. Other name. Atherosclerosis. Coronary artery disease, also called as atherosclerosis. This is when vessels, blood vessel which supply blood to the heart muscle. Okay, so when blood vessels supplying blood to heart muscles are affected, then person will get atherosclerosis. That is, blood vessel supplying blood to, blood supply to heart muscle is affected. That means any problem in blood vessel which supplies blood to heart muscle is affected. That means blood vessel cannot supply blood to heart muscle. Then the person will have this problem called atherosclerosis. Why it happens? Because blood vessel becomes narrow. So this is suppose normal blood vessel, okay, which is supplying blood. This is blood vessel. Sometimes what happens? Blood vessel becomes narrow at one point, like this. Blood vessel becomes narrow at one point. Why it becomes narrow? Or else normally I can draw and I can show when it becomes narrow. So this is normal blood vessel. Something will get deposited. Something will get deposited on the inner wall of artery. So that what happened? It becomes narrow. See, only this much space is left there. It became narrow. Or else if I have to cut and show, earlier it was, this was the diameter or the space available. Now, because something is deposited there, so it became very narrow. Only this much space is left there. Okay, what and all will be deposited? That is calcium, fat, cholesterol, fibrous tissue, fats, cholesterol, calcium, some fibrous means thread-like tissue will get deposited. So this is a normal tube, normal blood vessel which is supplying blood to heart muscle. Because fat, cholesterol, calcium and fibrous tissue gets deposited inside, so that what happens? You know, you imagine one pipe, okay, pipe. Then in the pipe, on the inner wall, if you paste something, you know, and make that hole, passage very narrow, then what happens? You see here, that is what happened here. Okay, so this is, till here it is fat deposition. You see, fat is deposited. Because of that, blood vessel became narrow. Only this much space is left there. No, I hope you can see that. Both the sides fat deposition or cholesterol deposition, then only one small gap is left there. That means blood vessel became narrow, very narrow. Andre blood vessel olagade iro jaga tumba kadme aagtade. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಕೊಲೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲ್ ಡೆಪಾಸಿಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ಡೇ one day all the fat will get deposited and it may completely block it. Andre poorthi block aagabodu, blood pass aagdene irabodu. Okay, when it becomes narrow, what happens? Blood has to be pumped with force, no? This is like pipe, okay, pipe which is delivering water. You hold a thumb or you close partially. ನೀವು ಅರ್ಧ ಬೆರಳು ಹಿಂಗೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಟು ಅ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಅಂದರೆ ನೀರು ತುಂಬ ದೂರದವರೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತದಲ್ಲ. ನಮಗೆ ನೀರನ್ನು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂತಿದ್ರೆ ಕಾರ್ ವಾಶ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಪೈಪಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ತಂಬ್ ಈ ಬೆರಳನ್ನು ಹಿಂಗೆ ಹಿಡಿತೀವಿ, ಸೊ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಅದೇ ಥರ ವ್ಯಾನ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯಾರೋ, ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ ನ್ಯಾರೋ. ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ? ಇನ್ಅಡೆಕ್ವೇಟ್ ಸಪ್ಲೈ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಟು ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಸಲ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಸಲ್ಸಿಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಬೇಕೋ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಹೋಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಸಲ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಗೋ ದೇರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೆಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್, ಕೊಲೆಸ್ಟ್ರಾಲ್, ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಸಿಯಂ, ಫೈಬ್ರಸ್ ಟಿಶ್ಯೂ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್. ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯಾರೋ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ ಹೋಲ್ ತುಂಬ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಹೋಲ್ ಸೈಜ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆಸಲ್ ಸಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಟು ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಸಲ್ is affected because of deposition of all these materials. Then the problem is called atherosclerosis. Okay, next third type of problem is angina. It is also called angina pectoris, chest pain, because oxygen supply to muscles of heart is less oxygen is supplied to heart muscle. This is called angina, or also called angina pectoris. This is one of the disorders. This is when chest pain, severe chest pain he gets because of less supply of oxygen to heart muscle. Inadequate means insufficient supply of oxygen to heart muscles. Okay, this is age old problem. This happens in old age, you know, but you know there are chances that it can happen at any age. Angina pectoris may occur in men and women of any age, but usually it is common among middle-aged or elderly people. Okay, it is more common in middle age. You know what is middle age? After 40, 45 years old. Okay, middle age or elderly, like more than 50, 60 years of age, it is more common. But you cannot neglect this. It can happen at any age. No, this problem can happen at any age, and this problem will happen when less oxygen is supplied to muscles of heart. Then the person will get chest pain. So if more oxygen is supplied, then the problem will be corrected. Okay, and last case is heart failure. People have a doubt with three kinds of words: heart attack, heart fail, no? Heart attack, heart fail, and cardiac arrest. Heart failure is a state when heart is not pumping blood effectively. Heart is not pumping blood effectively. This is again age old problem. Elderly people more than 50, 60 years old. Nowadays it is seen in more than 30 years old people also. Okay, so heart is not pumping blood effectively enough to meet the needs of the body. The person's body requires more blood to be pumped, but his heart is not pumping that much blood. Body is asking more blood to be pumped, but heart is not in a condition to pump more blood. Then, you know what happens? It is sometimes called congestive heart failure. It is also called congestive heart failure. Congestive means, congestion means block. This is when problem with difficulty in breathing also, because he is not taking, his breathing is not proper. Congestion of lungs is one of the main symptoms. Congestion of lungs means blockage of lungs. Lungs are blocked, so exchange of gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide, cannot get transported to heart. So that is why, because lungs are congested or lungs are blocked, congestion of lungs is one of the symptoms. If a person has breathing difficulty, his lungs are completely blocked, then it creates a problem of heart not pumping enough blood to the body. Okay. So heart failure is not the same like cardiac arrest. Cardiac arrest is when heart stops beating. Heart failure is when heart is failing to pump enough blood to the body. Okay. Heart is failing to pump enough blood. Means heart is pumping less blood to the body. Because of that, what are the symptoms? Congestion of lungs. Means lungs are blocked. Breathing doesn't happen. So that is why it is called congestive heart failure. Okay. Heart is not pumping enough blood. Then cardiac heart failure is different. Cardiac arrest is different. Okay. Cardiac arrest, that is heart stops beating. When heart stops beating, then it is called cardiac arrest. Heart failure is different, cardiac arrest is different. Cardiac arrest is when heart stops beating. Heart failure is when heart is not pumping enough blood. Heart is pumping less blood, okay, to the body. Then one more is there, heart attack. Heart attack when heart muscle is suddenly damaged by inadequate supply of blood. When less blood is supplied to muscle of heart, then what happens? Muscles of heart will be damaged. Because of the damage of muscles of heart, okay, then that is called heart attack. These three are completely different words. Heart attack is when muscle of heart is damaged. When muscle of heart is damaged, then it is called heart attack. Why it is damaged? Because of less supply of blood. Because of less supply of blood to muscle. Because less blood is supplied to the muscle, that is why muscle of heart is damaged. When enough blood is supplied, then muscle will be normal. Okay, so these three are three different words. Heart failure is different, cardiac arrest is different, heart attack is different. How it is different? See, heart failure is when heart is pumping less blood to the heart. Then cardiac arrest is when heart stops beating. Heart attack is muscle of the heart is damaged because of less blood supply. Okay, so with this, the chapter body fluids and circulation finished. This was a very interesting chapter. Okay, so in next class we will discuss chapter biomolecules, okay, which is very important because in second year chemistry also you have this chapter. Okay, it is more of chemistry part. We will learn it in the next class. Okay, keep watching my classes. Thank you.